Hello and welcome to the fourth part of our mixer optimization video series. If you haven't seen the first three videos, make sure to visit them before viewing this one. We have now automated the creation of different geometries with Inspire for Eden to simulate the mixing process with and export different query data. Since these simulations can be expensive to run, we want to build a machine learning model that can predict the query data or the performance indicators instantaneously based on the inputs of the mixer's design and operation. This will allow us to converge on an optimal design significantly faster than running hundreds of simulations with different configurations to get the best result. In order to build a machine learning model, we need to feed it some data to learn from, and therefore we're going to need a DOE, or a design of experiments. In HyperStudy, add a DOE and take the definition from setup. In the input variables tab, we're going to set up design constraints for our system. For example, since we only want integers for the rows and columns of the number of our paddles, we can do this in the modes by setting the data type to an integer. For the rest of the input variables, we set upper and lower bounds as well as their nominal value. We can also link variables together to constrain the design further. For example, in this case, we're linking both paddle widths and their stem diameters together so that they're always equal. We can also create new input variables and define their expression. In this case, we're defining a paddle angle fraction and setting limits for it inside the constraints tab. This is a global constraint that links two variables. In the specifications tab, we're going to choose a numerical method of sampling our parameter space defined in the input variables. Here, we will also choose the number of runs to be processed. For example, here, we're choosing the d-optimal approach with 8 runs. And as you can see, our parameter space has been sampled 8 times with different configurations for our input variables. The yellow boxes indicate items that either need calculation or processing. We can start this by clicking Evaluate Tasks. These simulations can be processed on a local machine or submitted to the Altair HPC cloud for fast processing. Click the link below to find out how to automatically send jobs to the Altair Unlimited cluster via HyperStudy. Our DOE simulations have now been processed, and we can see that for each run, we have a results.csv with the appropriate data from the queries. Since our DOEs are extensible by using an inclusion matrix, we can increase the dataset that we're working with. And we've done this 4 times to create 37 runs in total. By looking at the Pareto plots under the post-processing tab, we can investigate the effects of the input variables on the output responses to gain an understanding of parameter sensitivity and which factors are the most influential for each output, as well as how the two are correlated. Once we have enough DOE run data, we can add a machine learning model to it by adding a fit. Next, go to the specifications tab. Here we can choose which outputs we want to model and then select the origin for our dataset. We can then use HyperStudy's fast, which will try to pick the best model for each output automatically from a list. Or we can select directly a specific numerical method for our fit type. Once we click Apply, we can evaluate the model in seconds. Next, in the post-processing tab, we can look at the diagnostics of the predictive accuracy of our model. For example, we can look at the R-squared values, the regression equations, the regression terms, and much more. As we can see, the R-squared values for the average torque seem low, but we can take a deeper look at the model's performance by investigating the residuals. In this plot, we can see that the errors lie within one standard deviation and will only have a few outliers. In the table view, we can see the relative and absolute errors of our predictions. We are able to see that the predictive capabilities are better than initially shown in the diagnostics tab, and later in this video we will reassess the performance of the torque model using simulation verifications. We can now estimate the output responses based on input variables instantaneously without running any more simulations, which will significantly decrease the time of our optimization. If we are happy with the model selected, we can continue, and if not, we can add more data to our DOEs to improve accuracy. In the optimization approach, select the definition from the fit. In the optimization's output responses, we can define the output responses that we want to optimize. We will evaluate them from the fit, and we will then go into the objectives tab to add optimization goals. Here, for each output response, we'll set an objective. For example, we want to maximize mass flow and residence time for mixing uniformity, but we also want to minimize our average torque. We can also set constraints to the output responses if we so wish. We can then rename our goals. In the specifications, since we have multiple objectives, we'll choose the multi-objective genetic algorithm. This will start evaluating different configurations, trying to find the optimum based on the objectives that we defined. Here, we're evaluating thousands of parameter combinations extremely fast. The optimal solutions are found within seconds, and once the optimization has finished, we can view the optimal parameter combinations indicated by the green rows. These can also be visualized by going to the Optima tab under post-processing. The objectives we've set are competing, and therefore these Pareto fronts, which reveal trade-off curves, are shown. For example, if higher residency was wanted, the average torque would also increase. We can see all Optima by clicking Show Iterations, and we can sort through our goals to view the extremes. We will use these extremes to verify the predictive accuracy of our model. By going into Summary and Verify, a verification approach will automatically launch. Verifications allow us to automatically compare the predictions of the model to actual simulations. Under Specification, we can verify points. We will write down the index number of our extremes into the evaluation index box, and the simulations with their respective input variables will be processed for comparison. Once the simulations are finished, we can compare the results of the simulation to the predictions made by our machine learning model. In these plots, the metrics verified by the simulation are shown in blue, and the respective predictions from the model in red. Since there are no large errors at the extremes of our optima, we can be confident in our model's performance. In order to find a single optimum point with multiple objectives, we'll need to use a weighted sum approach. Add another optimization again, taking the definition from the fit. This time, we're adding an additional output, which calculates the total amount of paddles for which the evaluation is coming from the expression. Everything else is once again evaluated from the fit. In the Objective tab, add goals. Then, under Type, select More for each output. Under System Identification, select Minimize or Maximize Weighted Sum. Again, we're minimizing cost via torque and number of paddles, and we're also trying to maximize mixing uniformity, through residence time and mass flow. Here we will also set the weights for each output. The weights determine their relative importance, but keep in mind that the outputs are not normalized and therefore their units must be taken into consideration. Then select the genetic algorithm for our optimization method. The genetic algorithm will now converge on a single combination of parameters. Again, thousands of parameter combinations are evaluated in seconds, converging on a single optimum point. We can see the parameter combination the model has converged on. And again, verify its validity through simulations. In the specifications, pick verify optimal for a single optimum point. Once the simulation has finished, we can again see through the delta plots that no large errors are visible and that we have converged on a superior design. As a result, we are able to find superior design and operating conditions for the mixer, increasing efficiency when compared to the baseline setup. The cost-effective mixer on the right, which we have just converged on, has similar mixing uniformity with a decrease in cost in comparison to the original. On the other hand, we've also done another weighted sum approach to converge on a performance optimum, which has a 27% increase in particle residence time with a similar mass flow rate and only 4 more paddles in comparison to the original design.